I had the symptoms, the rectal bleeding, the urgency, and I just played games with my mind. Oh, it's hemorrhoids. Oh, it's really nothing. Oh, I ate some pot spices. I just didn't want to face it until it got to the point where I just couldn't deal with it anymore. That's when I went and had the colonoscopy. And the colonoscopy picked it up right away. It was colorectal cancer, was very low. And after we discovered it through the colonoscopy, I called a friend who's an oncologist here, Dr. Joseph Williams. And he said, I'll take care of it. I'll put the team together. Only thing you have to do is make your appointments. And so I kept the appointments, and the team came together with Dr. Layton, the medical oncologist, Dr. Goldberg for surgery, and then Dr. Zeitzer, Kenneth Zeitzer, for radiation. I think they anticipated my questions, and even when I didn't know enough to ask the question, they would say it in a way that made sense to me without hiding behind verbiage. You know, they talk regular talk, but and you will experience this, and this might happen to you. And if you need this, they do it all the time, so they know where you are, and they fill you in. After the week of chemotherapy, then we started the radiation. You know, I healed up and everything, and I said, oh man, I don't think I need any surgery because I'm feeling good. You know, I'm not having that urgency that you have. I don't know if I need any surgery. you're going to heal. The goal was, you're going to heal. And then we'll do this surgery. You know, when do you want the surgery? I said, well, my anniversary is always a good date. So I had the surgery on my anniversary, February 23rd. There was another couple there, a Spanish couple. And I don't know exactly what she was doing, but her husband was there every day. And so I would come up in the morning and say, hey, ¿cómo están? Do my little street Spanish and yada, yada, yada. And we talk. And so around Thursday of that week, he said, my pastor is coming tonight. Would you want him to pray for you? So the pastor came about 8 o'clock that night. The pastor, my friend, my friend whose wife was a patient, he started praying, adiós, adiós. And I went along, and you know, you learn that prayer is prayer regardless of the language. Anyway, I thanked them profusely, and I laid down a minute, and then I heard, will you do it now? Will you do it now? In my mind. And I knew exactly what it was, because when I was, I don't know, 45 years before, I'd heard that go to performing arts high school. And I know I'm going to play shortstop for the Dodgers. I'm not going to do any acting. Would you do it now? And I said, if I'm healthy, as soon as I'm healthy and able, I will go do it. And so I went when I got strong enough after the surgery and after all treatment. I went and took an acting class. I did a scene from The Patch of Blue, I believe, a Sidney Poitier scene with a blind girl, old classic. And it was a showcase, and the agent came in, and an agent said, I'm interested in you. They send you out, and then you all of a sudden you look up, and you're in the midst of this thing. and you know, you're working, and all of a sudden you're a working actor. In terms of Philadelphia, Invincible, where with Mark Wahlberg, where I play the cantankerous equipment manager, I'm a recurring actor on Boardwalk Empire. Previously we did The Wire, which is another one. I've done Law and Order and Cold Case and Rescue Me. So I try, and I'm having fun. This situation gave life to a dream that had been in waiting for over 45 years. At a time when most people are shutting down, I'm on a new learning curve. Thank you, Einstein family.